Hello again, this is Kevin Turner with TNT Brand Strategist. Just wanted to step you through how do you make sure that your resume is applicant tracking system ready. And LinkedIn helps you with this, and I think it's a fantastic opportunity to kind of understand that. So we're going to kind of walk through that. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to click on the jobs tab, right, of our LinkedIn account. So we'll click on that jobs tab. We're going to move over to resume builder. We're going to click on resume builder. We're now, you can see I've got actually some resumes saved in there. You can edit, delete those, whatever you want. You can apply with them and it will store a certain amount of resumes for you. It says, believe it or not, 4, but you can do up to 2. I've got 20 in there. So I just right now I've clicked on a fake resume I created just for this process and it's uploading it. So there's my fake resume, right? And we're going to go ahead and click next. And what it's going to do is it's going to do its analysis on this and it's going to compare it to a position that I want to apply to. So I'm going to type in positions. You always want to select the position from the drop-down box because LinkedIn understands what that position is. That's called a market value title. So from there, what you'll see on this right-hand side of the screen is you'll see things about, you know, what keywords it found in the resume that directly relate to that title, right, for a general posting. And then below that, it's going to give you suggested keywords. These are keywords it didn't find, but if you were to add those in, it could add value to your application, make it a closer match. So really good to kind of consider these. Now, the next step, and it's actually just behind my head here. Let me see if I can move myself over a little bit. And you see it right there, review formatting. So what we're going to do is we're going to review that formatting. And that means basically the system is going to review it. So what it told me initially is it didn't find a link to my LinkedIn. Even though I had it in there, couldn't read it, couldn't parse it. So it's going to tell me it's not found. Now, I could go right to Open Resume Builder, or I can go next to find out what else it discovered in the parsing. Now here, it looks like my quick summary was added to my first position. So that's no good. Second position, it couldn't find the company name. So looks like the position below that was fine. And so, you know, that's all good. So I'll click next here in a moment. And we're going to kind of go to the final area, which is degree for me. And it couldn't find my start date. I'm not sure if it was in there or it didn't find a description. So those are things I can add in now. Now, here's skills that it read. So it selected those from my resume and you can add or delete those very quickly, which is, you know, a nice thing to do. So the next thing we want to do is we want to open it with Resume Builder. So it's going to take that same content. You do have to type in a title again, bit of a hassle, but not bad. So we can type that in. We can use the same title. We can use a different title, whatever you want to do. And it's going to go through the process, bring back up those screens. But the difference is now you have a editable resume on LinkedIn that is going to be formatted to be accepted by the over 300 plus applicant tracking systems. Little blue pencils on the ends are where you do your edit. You notice it brought my LinkedIn URL in there. So here's this first part, and I want to clean this up a little bit because some things got in there that shouldn't be in there. So I'm just going to highlight them, delete them, or I could even save them and use them in a different moment. And that's what I'm going to do for the position below. Instead of me having to recopy it and rebuild the whole position in there, I'm just going to copy that section. And that way, when I go to the next component, which is my experience, I will have that ready to go. So what you can't see behind my head again is just the little button to click. Now, they're also going to give you some guide points. You know, basically, how do I do this? What makes a good summary section? So it's going to give you a little bit of information. So we're back here. You notice this, there's your keywords that are in, those are the keywords they're suggesting. Here's that position that was missing. So I'm gonna go in there, I'm gonna bring it in, I copy and paste. I can again copy and paste or I can just start typing. It is going to give me a drop-down box. Those drop-downs, remember, are your market value titles. You always wanna select them because they'll parse well within the systems. So. Basically, we'll kind of finish this up real quick here. We got to get our start dates in. because I copied all that information over, it's right below. That makes it really easy to kind of fix, right? So that's why I did that, and kind of shows you where everything is. Now, I'm going to take out the information I don't need now in the resume, because I've already got it a little bit above. And then I'll click that button that's right behind my head again. But here's some more kind of areas that you could improve on. So my apologies there. Let's go ahead and click that next. So here is my resume. You can see I've got everything correct. There's no areas. Actually, that one I could fix because it didn't bring across the company name because I didn't see the logo box. So a little bit of a clue, but that helps me in getting this all prepared. Everything else should be fine here. There we go. So everything looks fixing up a little formatting there. You want it to look right, right? I didn't have any spacing on the other one, so I'm not going to have any spacing in that one. It's kind of a attention to detail is what they see on the other side. And I just noticed that visually. And so we made that repair. There's a misspelling, marketing sales management. So that didn't parse over correctly either. Now, the drop-down box here is actually going to be the field of study that the university says it issues in that diploma. So really good to go with their guidance. We're going to get the years in there because, believe it or not, they're always going to ask when you apply. If you don't have it in there, you got to fix it. If you have to fix something on an application, your score is lower than if it was already there and you didn't have to fix it. So all these things are important to get done. And again, that's what this system is to do, is to get us all to a point where we don't have these issues. You can fill in other information towards the bottom, just clicking that X, fill the details in. It should bring in, you know, the components that you need. Most people don't know what those are. So it's a nice guide point. So same thing on honors and awards. All right. Now, I'm going to show you one thing. As we were looking earlier and we saw our keywords, key phrases, we can actually copy those and we can bring them into our edit. So we could actually, during this process, we could keyword this resume. And that's kind of neat that it's right there. And all you do is you copy it, bring it over, put it into the edit. But right now, everything is downloaded. I can now open that resume. This is the one I can apply to. I can save it on LinkedIn. They say up to 4, but I know I've got 20 in there right now. So I don't know why they have that limit, because it doesn't seem to apply. And you can use these when you are applying. So really nice little system. Just thought I would introduce it to you so that you can be sure that the resume you have is going to be applicant tracking system ready. So here's a process of me keywording this new business development. Maybe I'll bring it in here and implement it here. And I've now keyworded my resume. So you can kind of pull them across that way. So just a little example of that. Again, that's something we can save that in that resume and everything is complete. So that's formatting check, and it will help you make sure that your resume is ready for any applicant tracking system, that the information that you need to bring across is all there in the right order, in the way the system wants to see it, and it becomes a PDF file. Majority of the ATSs are going to take text-based PDF files. You can also convert that to a Word doc if you want, if you prefer that. Really, thank you. I appreciate your time. Please share this. Let other people know about it. And if you haven't subscribed, I would appreciate that as well. And hopefully this helps many make sure their resume is ready for the applicant tracking systems. Take care and have a great day. Bye-bye.